All right, Super Bowl 55. I think it's 55 at least. Who really even cares about that number? So what I'm doing is I did one video. This one is the over-under and the pick against the spread. And I'm doing the second video that'll be uploaded right after this that has all my prop bets for the game. So we're doing total and pick against the spread. Chiefs, Bucks, Super Bowl, whatever. Let's get into it.
Welcome to the source.
Hey, get the source.
The source.
Source.
The source.
Hey, get the source.
So a lot of books had this line open at Tampa Bay plus 3.5, and bets and money were both favoring the Bucks. In fact, my numbers were showing 64% of the bets on the Bucks, 67% of the money on Tampa, which explains why the line dropped from 3.5 down to 3. Now, as soon as the line hits 3, you can see the public react. Here comes the Kansas City Chiefs money. The bet's just about even out, close to 50-50. This is Tuesday of this week now. Bets are just about 50-50. The money has flipped. Now 63% of the money is favoring Kansas City at this point. So let's fast forward all the way to right now. We're still at 3. It did touch back at 3.5 for a day or two, but we're back at 3 now. Bets and money favoring the Chiefs, but slightly. We're looking at 59% of the bets, 58% of the money. So the Chiefs have the slight edge when it comes to bets. Tampa Bay plus 3, Kansas City minus 3. Let's make a pick. So everyone who subscribes to this channel knows this is the part of the video where I break down the two teams and get all in depth. But there's no need for that in this game. This is the Super Bowl. It's the Chiefs versus the Bucks. We know everything. In my opinion, there's two major factors as to the outcome of this game. I'm gonna call them the Kyle Kerms factors because I'm conceited and I like making cool 3D graphics. So I'm gonna share what both of them are right now. Kyle Kerms factor number one, the deep pass. Tampa Bay is real susceptible to the deep ball and we've all kind of forgot about it. We've forgotten about it because it's been hidden for the last month. NFC Championship game, it was cold out, tough to throw the deep ball when it's real cold. The week before that, they played the Saints. Drew Brees physically can't even reach to throw a deep ball. He has to throw a moon ball. So there is no deep passing game against New Orleans. The week before that, they played Washington. Not much of a deep passing threat there either. You know who does have a deep passing attack? Oh yeah, the Kansas City Chiefs, their opponent, who have maybe the best deep passing attack I've ever seen. I mean, top three? I mean, it's gotta be the best passing, deep passing attack I've ever seen, I would have to say. So the Bucks, who have been susceptible to the deep pass all year, are now going against everyone's nightmare when it comes to the deep pass. Pat Mahomes, Tyreek Hill, and the squad. Kyle Kerms factor number two, Tampa Bay's pass rush. Now, 2 weeks ago, I'm watching the conference championships game, right? I'm watching the first one, and I had already made up my mind that I'm betting Kansas City to cover in the Super Bowl. The games haven't even played yet. I knew they were gonna cover against Buffalo, and I already decided I'm betting Kansas City to cover in the Super Bowl. But I'm watching this Packers-Bucks game, and this pass rush is insane. Shaq Barrett and Jason Pierre-Paul combined for 5 sacks in that game. And it's not just the 5 sacks, they were in Rodgers' face all game. I was always like, yeah, I'm definitely betting the Chiefs in the Super Bowl because I don't see any aspect of any team that would scare me out of taking Patrick Mahomes to cover in the Super Bowl. But then I'm watching that pass rush and I was like, that's it. That's an aspect that would scare me away from betting the Chiefs. I'm not saying I'm definitely betting against the Chiefs, I'm saying that's scary. If the Bucks pass rush comes out like it did against the Packers, they will win the Super Bowl hands down. That was nuts. Aaron Rodgers couldn't do anything. All right, let's get to the picks. I'll do the total first. Everyone, the public's all over the over, right? Everyone loves talking about these offenses. Ooh, Patrick Mahomes, Tom Brady, Tyreek Hill, Mike Evans, Antonio. They love talking about these offenses. No one shows the defenses love. You know what? I will. I'll take the under here. I'm going under 56.5 points. I like both of these defenses to step up in this game, especially Tampa Bay's. I think Tampa Bay's defense is going to show out in this game. And for the pick in Super Bowl 50, whatever, I'm taking the GOAT, Tom Brady, Bucks plus 3. And trust me, if you're in the comments like, no, no way, I'm taking the Chiefs, I don't fault you. This is the Super Bowl. There's really not much handicapping to do. The books aren't setting any traps. There's nothing to read. The Super Bowl is basically a coin flip when it comes to the pick against the spread. It's the prop bets where you can find value, and I'll show you that in the next video. Also, I'll include this little parlay. I'm definitely going to be betting this. I'll probably bet this pretty heavy. I'm taking Tampa Bay money line, which is at plus 140. I'm taking under and teasing it down to 52.5. Under 52.5, which is plus 135, for a total of plus 440. And I'll be betting that pretty heavily. Maybe two or three units on that parlay, because I like it a lot. So whether you're following me, fading me, whatever, let's have some fun. I mean, I am 5-1 out of my last 6 NFL picks against the spread, 2-0 in conference championships, 3-1 in the divisional weekend. But hey, if you want to fade me, I think it's okay. You're entitled to, you're allowed to. I just don't recommend it. Make sure you check out the prop bets video. I'm going to be uploading it probably about a half hour after this one.